Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this tutorial, I will show you how to use the Hot Export tool as a replacement for Mapzen Metro-Extracts. Mapzen has announced they will be closing down January 31st, 2018. Mapzen has also stated they are considering making a copy of existing Metro-Extracts available. You will no longer be able to use their services, such as custom extracts. I've looked at some alternatives for getting the shapefiles necessary. I decided the best alternative is using the Humanitarian Openstreetmap Team HOT export tool. This is a free service that lets you create customized extracts of Openstreetmap data in various file formats, including shapefiles. If you are using Metro-Extracts OpenStreetMap shapefiles, you can replace them with the Hot Export shapefiles. If you are using my map art tutorials, nothing else will change. We will just be getting the map data from a different source. All of my tutorials before 2018 will still work. Just replace the Mapzen shapefiles with Hot Export shapefiles. I really like the Hot Export tool. Not only does it allow you to visually expand or shrink the area that the shapefiles cover, but it allows you to reduce the amount of features to only the ones you choose. These two advantages allow for efficient shapefiles that are only as large as necessary to get the job done. In this tutorial, we will walk through how to access the shapefiles needed for South Bend, Indiana. To begin, open the Hot Export tool in your browser. A link is in the description area. You need to log in to use the services. I already have a login, so it asks me if it's okay to use my preferences. Press Grant Access to allow the use of my preferences. The login is the same as your OpenStreetMap.org login. So if you already have a login there, you can use that login. Once logged in, choose the Start Exporting button. The Hot Export tool screen opens. On the left side are four tab pages: Describe, Formats, Data, and Summary. On the right side is a visual map to aid you in selecting the area that you are exporting. Now we'll fill in the four pages. In the Describe page, give the export a name. Here I use South Bend. Add a description to help you or others, if you make the export public, understand what it is. In the project area, give it a project name, as you may have more than one export relating to this. In the Formats page, check the file type. I checked Shapefile. In the Data page, it is easiest to use the Tag tree. This option allows you to configure your data with only the features and keys you need, thus keeping the resulting shapefiles at a minimum size for your usage. If you hover over the features, an info box on the right shows you the geometry types and keys associated with it. You can expand the feature by clicking on the greater than symbol. For example, for localities, I expanded it and chose administrative boundary, because I need to have the boundary of the city in my export. Now when I click the symbol to shrink the locality views, a little black square is shown next to the localities feature, which indicates there is a child checkbox active. Next, continue configuring the tag tree for what we need for basic map art. Your configuration will differ depending on your needs. Under education, I chose college and university in case I have a college town. Under Localities, Administrative Boundaries is still active. Under Natural, I chose Coastline and Water Body. Under Transportation, I chose Airport and Road. Under Water, I chose Waterway. These are the basics needed for map art. If you think you may need to save these tag tree settings for future use, click the YAML tab. The YAML code represents the changes you made on the tag tree. Copy the code, then paste it into a plain text editor and save it on your computer. Later in this tutorial, I will show you how to set up a configuration for these settings. Press Next to continue to the summary page. Finally, on the summary page, uncheck Publish this export, as we are not making this export public. Next, we will set the map boundaries. To start, click the globe icon to change to the default world view. Notice that the search and all the tools options are red and therefore available. You can use the search box to find the South Bend default view. Type in South Bend in a search box. Leave your cursor in the search box for a few seconds, and the South Bend options will appear. In this case, choose South Bend, St. Joseph County, Indiana, United States. A blue overlay appears showing the default view. This view is pretty tight around the city boundaries. I prefer to expand the boundaries using the This View tool. Click the X above the search options to turn off the search. Now click the This View tool. The new view has expanded. However, in some cases, you may want to make the view smaller. For example, to show just the downtown area of a large city. Or you may want to make it larger to show a larger metropolitan area. To modify further, click the X above the This View tool. This turns off this view. Now click the box tool icon. The cursor will change to a large cross shape. Click the mouse once to set a corner. With your hand off the mouse button, then move the mouse as demonstrated to create a rectangular selection. When satisfied, click the mouse once again. The new area border should appear as a transparent blue overlay. If you choose too large of an area, the program won't accept it, and the covered area won't change. You could reduce the area size, or keep the same area size, but modify the tag tree on the data page to include only the tags that you need. Most cities will either fit best in a square, portrait, or landscape orientation. Adjust the area accordingly, but keep in mind to leave some extra room on all sides. If you want to readjust the selection, click the X over the box tool to turn it off, then click the box tool again, then repeat the process as before. For the final South Bend export, I click the World View button to reset everything, then turned off the box tool, then searched for South Bend. Once displayed, I turned off the search tool and then chose the This View tool. This allows for some expansion of the city boundaries and is the recommended method for maps used in the map art tutorials. Next, we will export the file. While in the summary page, choose Create Export. An info box will appear letting you know that the report is running. When it's finished running, a green box will appear in the status area saying Completed. If you wish, you can click the link at the bottom of the status box and download the file. This link is also sent to your email account. However, to retrieve it, you must be logged into the Hot tool. At any later time, you can log back into the Hot Export tool. Choose Exports from the menu. Then choose your South Bend export. You will be shown the export data for South Bend. If you click the Features button, you will be shown the YAML code for the features used in the map. You can highlight and copy the code if you wish. You also have the option to rerun, clone, or delete. You can save your tag configuration settings for future use. When you configure the tag tree, the YAML code is updated. This code represents the changes you made on the tag tree. You can save the information as a configuration. I am assuming you have the YAML code copied to a text file as explained earlier. Open the Configs tab on the main menu. When you open this, your workflow is lost, so don't do this until you are finished making and exporting your work. Click the Create New Configuration button. Type a name in for your config, for example, Map Art Basic Tags. Type in a description, settings for typical Map Art project. In the Feature Selection area, paste the YAML code you copied earlier. Uncheck Publish this configuration if you don't want it public. In my case, I will leave it checked so my tutorial users can find it. Click the Create Configuration button. You now have a configuration you use whenever you need MapArt basic tags. For example, you are creating another new export, and you are on the data page. Click the Configs tab. Within the MapArt Basics tags, Config, click the Load YAML button. If you click the YAML tab, you will see that the code has been updated with the config. Your tree tag appears empty, but the YAML code controls what happens. So you have successfully updated the tag settings. You are done with the data page. This concludes the tutorial. Hope you've liked it.